2021 has a new unicorn. It's the 14th unicorn of 2021. It is the banking software platform provider Zeta. It has raised $250 million in a series round led by SoftBank Vision Fund 2. So after, you know, having a quietish 2020, SoftBank also making big investments earlier in the year, of course, it made Nisho into a unicorn. Now it is the turn of Zeta. Joining me is the co-founder, Bhavin. Bhavin, congratulations. You know, it's a big fundraise, $250 million by SoftBank Vision Fund 2. Sodexo is a minority investor. The valuation soaring from what, about $300 million to $1.5 billion. How does it feel?
Sorry about that. It's just another regular day out here, I guess. I mean, it's exciting. I think the team's sort of exhilarated because it's sort of a testament to the kind of effort they've put in and the vision, sort of scalable vision that we're delivering to. And it's a huge sort of acknowledgement of the kind of platform that the entire team has built. But yeah, otherwise it's still the beginning for us in this sort of ambitious journey that we set out to achieve.
So tell me something, banking platform, I was reading up, is what, a $300 billion opportunity globally. In India, you have some of the biggest names as your clients, HDFC Bank, Kotak Bank, Axis Bank, IndusInd Bank, Yes Bank, RBL. How was COVID, the lockdown? Did you see banks upgrade their software, become more modern?
No, absolutely. So, I mean, you're right, by the way, that, you know, banking IT spends worldwide at $300 billion per year. So it's a massive industry and opportunity. And with Zeta, we've actually built the world's only fully modern stack that can enable a bank to launch any retail banking product on our platform. Last year has been interesting year in the journey interesting year for the world in terms of COVID. And we certainly have seen a meaningful difference in, so it's, I guess it's had both, you know, positive impacts and negative impacts. From a positive standpoint, I think the banking industry, you know, in some sense, a bank branch has become almost irrelevant, and digital transformation and digitization has become much more the need of the hour, right from origination, you know, opening accounts, supporting customers, providing them information and insights, and Zeta's platform is best capable for providing a modern digital experience for debit cards, credit cards, loans, deposits, pretty much everything that a bank needs. On the other hand, of course, it has made a significant impact to, you know, individuals across the country in terms of, you know, whether it's access to financial services and many other aspects, and we hope to sort of help that. And it certainly impacted our team and employees in ways that could have never been imagined. And that's, so I guess, in some sense, work has been impacted. But overall, definitely, we've seen banks be much more, you know, receptive to and understand the need of a rapid acceleration to operating fully digitally and fully in the cloud, as opposed to sort of, you know, leveraging infrastructure and brick and mortar.
So you have previously said that Zeta is like a bank in a box. So when you're seeing that banks are becoming more conscientious, can you tell us that are they increasing their budget for upgradation, for new software, more modern software? Because while India is pioneering the digital payment highways, it perhaps has the best one in the world, there has been criticism as far as the banking software infrastructure goes, how it's not been able to meet the robust demand.
Absolutely, with the nail on the head. I mean, if you think about it, banking software is still stuck in the stone ages, right? Banks today use 10, 15, 20, 30 different software vendors who have built legacy stacks that were, you know, created 30 years ago. If you think any other industry in the world, you're not using software today that was built 20, 30, even 15 years ago, right? Whether it's CRM, ERP, accounting, etc. But banking somehow has yet to be disrupted. In fact, space travel has been disrupted before banking software. And so in some sense, it's no surprise that many banks are slow to innovate, not because they don't want to sort of, you know, launch features and launch products faster. They provide more user experiences, not because they want to, but because their existing software stacks don't enable them to create modern experiences for Gen Z and millennial customers and what their customers expect. And so certainly banks are now actively looking to induct, you know, platforms like Zeta, which are cloud-based. Some of the benefits we provide is more efficiency, lower cost of operations, because with Zeta, banks don't need to buy expensive hardware, data centers, large, you know, network operating center and system operating center teams, licenses, assemble all of it together, spend a lot of money on integration. They save all of these costs by leveraging a modern technology stack and still are able to provide benefits to their customers. And so definitely banks are, I think the challenge is not as much the budget as how do we go about doing it. And we're actually helping many of these banks across the globe leverage the cloud meaningfully and migrate legacy from legacy stacks to new age platform that Zeta provides, in the lowest risk or risk-free manner.
So can you tell me a little bit that as you help banks become more modern, move away from the antiquated 50-year-old software, you're talking about cloud, what is your differentiator? It's a $300 billion opportunity, that's the size of the market. So why should someone go in for Zeta as opposed to some of the other global solutions out there?
So there's actually no other global solution out there that's modern and full stack, right? As of today, vast majority of the banking software vendor landscape is companies that were built in 1970s, 1980s, 1990s, and many of these software started their journey back then. There is no fully modern stack. There are some vendors building one solution, you know, point solution like a core banking or some parts of processing. Zeta is the only platform across the world where we have core banking, credit processing, debit processing, loan management, deposits, mobile apps, web apps, pretty much everything you need to run an entire bank. You can launch credit cards, debit cards, loans, deposits, savings, pretty much anything you want to for retail customers and wholesale customers. So there isn't a parallel platform out there that can actually enable the same thing. And the benefits that our OmniStack provides is speed and agility. So it enables a bank to launch products in weeks as opposed to months or years. Much more modern user experience. We have a white label modern mobile app that banks can customize to provide a much more modern experience to their customers. And we're also open banking ready. So the entire platform has 100% API coverage that enables banks to partner with fintechs and third party app developers to leverage, you know, and participate in the fintech revolution.
Bhavin, I want to now also ask you that how big a game changer is it to have a SoftBank Vision Fund 2 on board? You know, you're getting SoftBank on board. Look at the way it understands the financial ecosystem. Last year, of course, the SoftBank Group was being called also the NASDAQ whale. How important is this? Where does it fit in as far as your global aspirations go?
We are extremely excited to bring and have SoftBank on board as a partner. We think they're an outstanding organization. They are a behemoth. The size of their funds and the scale of their operations is second to none. The amount of capital deployed is second to none. And what that provides them, I mean, Zeta Credit already operates in eight global markets. So we're present in North America, Brazil, Vietnam, Philippines, Spain, Italy, UK, and India. And with SoftBank, we not only get, you know, significant capital, which we're looking to use to accelerate our global expansion, but we are also majority and significant investors, I would say, in a large number of fintech companies and financial service companies across the globe. And as a SoftBank family company, if you think about it, you know, we have access to and connections into and deep inroads into these sort of fintechs and financial service companies. So Zeta is a technology services provider. We provide our technology to banks and fintechs. And with SoftBank, we have the opportunity to sort of leverage that connects and their portfolio companies to provide our platform and our technology to their portfolio companies and their connections across the globe.
So clearly a global play is going to take place at $45 million. That's a lot of money. What do you plan to do with it now that, you know, you've got SoftBank on board? Are M&As very much on the table?
Thanks for that. No, so actually, there's two primary buckets that we're looking to spend the capital in. One is, as I said, Zeta. We've spent more than $70 million thus far building out the platform into the most comprehensive banking platform that exists globally. And roughly 25 to 30% of the capital that SoftBank is invested, so roughly, you know, $70 million or so, 50 to $70 million will be spent over time in further upgrading, expanding our capabilities and adding newer products to our kitty. Enterprise payment solutions, you know, solutions for corporates, additional capabilities for end users, etc. And then the remaining 75%, so a bulk of the capital close to almost $180 million, $200 million, is going to be spent on rapidly expanding into all other markets. So we're looking to, you know, set up teams and offices in upwards of 30 different countries across the globe. And over the course of the next 18 to 24 months, bulk of the capital is going to go towards that go-to-market and expanding into the rest of Europe, further expanding to UK, North America, further expanding to Latin American countries, Southeast Asia, and the rest of Asia Pacific.
Okay, so big plans over there. But you know, before I let you go, Bhavin, this is not your first startup. You called very often a serial entrepreneur. So if I could lean back on your journey and what we're seeing today, the massive gush of liquidity, the big checks that are being handed out, unicorns, being announced every other week. For Zeta, it's of course a big moment, but as an entrepreneur, you have to stay grounded as well, right? So you've got this milestone. You've told us a little bit about your expansion plans, but what about road to profitability? Do we not talk about that enough?
I definitely think we don't talk about that enough. So I mean, I will say that I've been a single entrepreneur all my life. This is the first time I'm raising institutional capital. So the first time I've actually taken external funding from a purely financial investor. My first company, DirectEye, and then after that, Radix and Nova, they've all been self-funded. Both DirectEye and Radix were profitable. And I've always had a huge focus, and I fundamentally believed in, you know, the notion that this is a generate profit. Now, you know, I do believe in growth, and I do believe in investment, etc., but I do believe also that this should always have a, you know, strong revenue and profit outcome. With Zeta, we ourselves already signed on contracts that would result in a couple of $100 million sort of annual revenue once we finish delivering on them over the course of the next few years. And we therefore expect that by 2023, we will actually be EBITDA positive. And if all turns out well, this will likely be the first and last capital round that we need purely from the standpoint of, you know, needing capital for expansion. We're certainly open to strategic partnerships and investments in JVs in the future. But we expect that we have a strong focus on revenue, and we expect that we'll actually turn operationally profitable in the next couple of years.
So it was SoftBank that approached you. If you as an entrepreneur have never looked at external funding and you've done it this time round, why? And the reason I'm asking you that is also on behalf of, you know, maybe the first time entrepreneurs, new founders, young entrepreneurs who are tuning in, when to go in for external funding. Right now, of course, we have a massive gush in liquidity. What made you decide to go in for it?
Sure. No. So, I mean, so firstly, of course, we actually spoke to SoftBank and many other funds in the course of this fundraising. So, first time sort of fundraising experience for me, so it was quite interesting in that regards. And I think what we're looking for specifically is smart capital, right? So, you know, in this day and age, I think capital is kind of almost cheap, and a good entrepreneur, a good sort of idea, decent product market fit can definitely raise funding out there. But I guess our goal, and I would, you know, my advice to entrepreneurs would be to sort of seek value beyond just capital. We had a bunch of different firms that were interested in investing in us, and all of them really great companies and individuals. I think with SoftBank, the two things we're looking for is, you know, capital and a fair valuation, which we got from a few sort of players. And then we were also looking for a partner who can meaningfully open doors for us, who can connect us with various fintechs and banks, who can open the right doors and assist us in obtaining the right contracts. And that's the reason why we chose SoftBank. We believe they have a global reach and a sizable pool of capital that enables them to connect us to the right folks. And so I think, you know, typically, whether it's, you know, whether you're a first time or a second time entrepreneur, whether you're an early stage or a late late stage entrepreneur or a late stage fundraise, I think it's always important to kind of decide outside of capital, what is the additional value, whether it's mentorship, whether it's connections, whether it's help scaling, whether it's help, you know, expanding in a different geography that you can use to your benefit, and then potentially try and find, I would say, investors that are more partners that understand your vision, that will support you in your vision, and that will actually be able to add value beyond just capital.
Okay. With that, we're completely out of time. Subhavin, thank you so much for taking the time out, for joining us here on ET Now. Congratulations again to you and the entire team.
Thank you so much.